All right, this is one of the most trending topics right now, and it's Harry Styles, and he shaved his head. As you can see, he has had some classic haircuts in the past. I mean, his hair is, like, glorious. But here it is, the most recent photo of his shaved or buzzed head. Now, why would someone do something like that? It could be numerous reasons. One, maybe he has a new part for a role he's doing in a movie. He just wanted to change his look up. But usually with something this dramatic, it's gotta be for a specific reason, especially since his hair is like such a huge part of his look. Let me know in the comments below what you think of his new buzz cut. This probably looks like a number one guard, you know, to be honest with you. Nothing, you know, very, very simple. Now, I have a surprise for you all. I have Harry Styles here on my channel. That's Harry Styles right there. What I'm going to be doing in this, because I can't leave you guys hanging with just doing a, you know, not showing any sort of Harry Styles haircut. This is a haircut from his, I believe, his Golden video, one of his songs. And I know a lot of you may want that longer Harry Styles look, or even just a longer look in general. But what I'm doing here is really focusing on creating a really nicely layered shape. And I know I sped this up a little bit just to kind of get through this a little quicker. But the key to this haircut and all of these types of haircuts is making sure that the hair is layered properly. And what I'm doing is I'm simply just pulling the hair straight out from the head and following the pattern of the haircut. This is done by using the guide, which is the section of the previously cut section. And that's what gives you that guidance. That's why it's called the guide, to create an even balanced haircut. Now, I would highly suggest going to a experienced hairstylist for this. Do not just walk into a random barbershop that charges $15 for a haircut, or a chain salon that charges $12 for a haircut and they do it in 15 minutes. This is a somewhat advanced haircut. It requires understanding, you know, shapes, layers, the way the hair falls, all that kind of stuff. So what I'm doing is I'm literally layering the top of the head, the corners, and the sides. This is probably the most important part of this whole thing. And it's making sure that, you know, you go in and check. Now, what I'm doing here is really cool because I'm actually flipping the hair upside down and cutting it. And this is great for people who want to see hair flip out. If you flip it up and cut it, it's going to actually remove some weight and allow the hair to have a bit more freedom so it can flip up. It's a little trick, a little thing I've learned over the years. I'm actually, if you want to get the hair to flip up, flip it and then cut it, right? And if it's something that your stylist or barber doesn't really know about, then that's on them. They need to watch more videos. But anyway, so as you can see, I'm flipping my fingers upwards, and that's going to help me alleviate some weight and give it a bit more movement and texture. So I'm trying to cut the shape into the hairstyle. A lot of point cutting, a lot of just, you know, free flowing, making sure it's all even. And now I'm even going in and removing some weight even more, adding a lot more texture with some free flowing stuff. And now I'm just checking the balance to make sure it's all even. We want even Steven here. So now I'm using a diffuser, and what I'm doing is I'm twisting the hair with my fingers. And I would suggest, if you use Tidal Wave, that's a great start. But Tidal Wave is something that's really going to help give the hair some texture. This was done on perfectly straight hair. So if you want to achieve these types of waves or even volume, then this is a great technique of how to do it, by using the diffuser, doing some hair twists, and creating that wave and that volume in the hair. If you don't do any of these techniques, you don't have the right haircut, you're not using Tidal Wave, you're not going to achieve the same result. The reason the hair is able to have that sort of movement like you're seeing, once again, is simply because of how I cut it, all the work I did, all the removing of the weight that I put into it. And again, like I mentioned before, this is not just a random going to a barbershop haircut, okay? If you do have wavy hair naturally, then this will work great. Another key thing is to see the length. I didn't cut it over the ear. So the hair is covering the ear. It's probably about cut right down to the bottom of the ear, and I angle it downwards, like you're seeing there, towards the back and hairline. But leaving that hair allows you to cover those empty gaps. That's why it's important that you cut on an angle, all right, and you follow. Actually, what I did is I cut the shape into it. Now, let's take a look at this. This is the layering. As you can see, when you pull the hair straight out like that, you're removing the weight from the hair, and that is what's going to give it that freedom and flexibility to be able to look like it's curly or look like it's wavy. And then the flipping that I did when I cut it, again, it allows for a lot of versatility and movement in the shape. So, you know, this is one of those haircuts you could spray tidal wave, you can scrunch it, set it and forget it, or you can use a diffuser and you can, you know, diffuse it in like this, like I mentioned before, and displayed, where you just kind of scrunch and use a diffuser, and then you can set it and forget it. These layers, what I'm holding up right now, it's really important. If you want a shorter version of this, then you cut it shorter. If you want to have a longer version of this, then you leave it longer, right? But you see the length here. See how it's sprung up? You got to make sure you have some length in the front. The length of your hair in the front should be able to go all the way down to probably like the tip of your nose, right? But because of the way what happens when you scrunch hair, it's going to shrink back up. So having that hair length on top throughout the sides is definitely important. This is not a haircut done with clippers. This is all scissors. I didn't use any razors, anything like that. It was all just done by hand with the scissors, and that, to me, in my opinion, gives the best result. So let me know in the comments below if you enjoyed this video. If you want to use any of my products, use code YouTube20. That's YouTube20 at shop.thesalonguy.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.